So to take an online course, the first step is going to be logging into the course portal. Mine is easy to find on my website, just timeishoney.com, and click on student login. This is where you can enter your credentials. If you need any help with your password, you can just click down here. My pro tip here is to bookmark this page so that it's always easy to access. We'll talk about this more in the course, but I've taken dozens of online courses over the years and I keep them all organized in this courses folder. That way I don't have to look them up every time I want to access them, and it's easy for me to jump into the course or go back and reference something. So I recommend bookmarking it. In Chrome, you just hit this star up here and then you can add it into one of your bookmark folders if you want. One secret to completing courses and getting a lot out of them is making it easy for yourself to jump in and access it. So once you've logged in, the course portal will look like this. Any courses that you've purchased from me will show up here, so you should see time transformation. To enter the course, just click on the course name, and it's going to open the course with sort of an outline view along the left side. So you'll see that there is a welcome video, and then the 8 core lessons, and then there's going to be some bonus content as well. If you haven't downloaded your workbook yet, you can find that under the welcome video. All of the free resources, such as the daily page and the habit tracker, are under bonus content and then free resources. And you can just scroll down to look at them, but this is where you can get like the course calendar or any of the free planner designs that I provided to you. There's also a section called help and tutorials. Right now, it just has this short video that a lot of you probably watched already that just shows you how to set up your profile picture, grab your affiliate link, that stuff. But you're welcome to let me know if something doesn't make sense or you need a quick tutorial on a specific process or lesson, and I'll make quick videos and add them to this section for you. But most of your time will be spent within the lessons, so let's click on lesson 1 to see what this layout looks like. First, you'll see a video at the top. This is the most interactive learning option. It will have a video slide deck along with my voice walking you through the lesson. But if you scroll down on the page, you'll see other options for learning. So you can listen to this as a podcast, you can read through the lesson's transcript, or you can click to flip through the slides of the PDF. We all learn a little differently, so do whatever works for you. My learning style would be to watch the video, but then I would probably open the PDF to reread some of the information. Further down, you'll see a comment section. This is where you can ask me any questions about the lesson. I'll be in here every day to interact with you and make sure that your questions get answered. And although you are welcome to email me, I think that trying to keep questions in the comment section is helpful because that way everyone can benefit from the conversation. There are also some simple navigation buttons here so you can jump back to the previous lesson, move on to the next lesson, and you can also mark this lesson as complete. Up in this text area, I've also noted how long the lesson is, just so you know before you even start it. And I've also put the action items from your workbook right here, so it's all in one place for you. Going back up to the video player, there are some really cool things that I want to show you about it. First, if you do better with reading, you can turn on closed captions by clicking on this CC icon here. You can set the language for the captions to either English, Danish, or Spanish, depending on your preference. And of course, I think that this is really cool because I'm such an efficiency nerd, but you can also search the video by clicking on closed captions, going up to search video. It'll open up a search bar and you can type in any keyword or phrase that you want, and it's going to search the entire transcript of the video to show you where in the video that shows up. And you can actually just click on it and it'll jump right to that part of the video. So that's really nice if you want to jump back in to review anything, or you're looking for a specific thing in the video. So when I post the recordings of the office hours, if you don't attend those live, this will be a really good tool to use to jump in and search for answers to the question that you asked or any information in that video about topics that you're interested in learning more about. The other icons in this bottom right corner are going to be your volume control, settings where you can control the speed of the video and the quality, and then changing it to go full screen. So what you'll do is just progress through the lessons along the left side here, or using these navigation buttons down at the bottom to go one lesson at a time at whatever pace works for you. That's really the basics of navigating the course. You are welcome to reach out to me if you have any other questions. I'm happy to make additional tutorials and put them under that help section. So just let me know what you need. I hope you're feeling ready to dive in and get started. So go ahead and navigate to the welcome video or lesson 1 whenever you're ready.